Hello everyone, this is Strawberry Shorty back with my list of games to grab before the eShop closes. The previous recording ended up split in two, so I'm recording a new intro for this part, and we're going to be shifting a little into time management. So let's get right into that, and I'm sorry if this transition is a little strange. Now we're kind of shifting into time management titles, which overall are preferable to play on PC, I find, but these ones are not on PC as far as I can tell. So, we have Valet Parking 1989. I covered this on my DSiWare list. You're a valet and you use the stylus to park and retrieve cars by driving them to and fro. It gets pretty difficult near the end. The biggest problem, really, is that you have to start the story mode all over from the beginning if you fail. So, yeah. Besides that, not actually a bad game. Parking Star 3D. Basically, because I played the above game, I downloaded the demo for this one. I haven't had a chance to play it yet, but, you know, free demo. No reason not to give it a try. My Little Restaurant, a DSiWare time management game along the lines of Diner Dash. It's got a cute style and a cute little story, nothing impressive, but it's weakened a lot by the DS's small screen. You have to move the camera around to different sections of the restaurant, and this makes the game needlessly hard, though I guess you could consider it a challenge. Also, it seemed like the customers you got were randomized, meaning it was entirely possible you would be unable to get all 3 stars for that level if you didn't get enough big groups. I don't really regret buying it, but it's a bit of a mess. Also, not sure why the one dude on the opening title image thingy is see-through. He is not a ghost at any point during the game. Brunch Panic. Manage a breakfast cart and serve people, as far as I can tell. Have not had a chance to play this one, but that's almost certainly how it plays. Aeroporter. You have to act fast to sort luggage. This one never goes on sale, so I've unfortunately not had a chance to play it, but it's by level 5, apparently. Conveni Dream and Gourmet Dream. These are two time management games that seem cute, but a little rough. Again, I have no idea how they play, but they are on sale from time to time. Rusty's Real Deal Baseball. So this is one of those games that you will often see on other people's lists of titles to pick up, and the initial download is free, but I'm pretty sure you have to buy the actual content within the game. I think it's managing a baseball team. I'm not sure. There's the main character is like an animal. I don't know. The Style Savvy series. Series of games where you own a boutique and help clients get the outfit of their dreams. It's a series that honestly looks really nice. Kind of got a cute tint to it. I found it very enjoyable, the titles that I've played. You can dress up your character and whatnot. There's multiple titles on the eShop, but only Styling Star never got a physical release. Fashion Doll Atelier. Originally a series of DSiWare titles called Anne's Doll Studio. This is a pretty nice looking dress-up game. I did cover it in my DSiWare videos, and it's eShop only. There's not a lot to say about this one. You design a doll-like girl, choose a background and so forth, take a picture. I really like it personally. Like, the graphics are really pretty. Since we're still talking cute games, semi-dress-up games at this point, Cute Witch Runner and Dress to Play Cute Witches. So, covered in my DSiWare videos, these are both games where you control a witch flying and trying to avoid obstacles while collecting stars, seemingly without end, which makes it feel kind of pointless. The games are different in terms of levels, enemies, and gameplay. And Dress to Play allows you to design your character, well, on a very basic level. Also, the Cute Witch and Cute Witch Runner is one word, so keep that in mind. There's also another Dress to Play. It's like Magic Bubble or something, which is like a match 3 sort of game, similar to like Tetris, but yeah. Radio Hammer, a digital-only rhythm game. We're switching into rhythm games, by the way. Digital-only rhythm game where you play as a girl with a huge hammer and you have to defeat enemies to the beat. And the similar Harmonite, which you control a guy in this one. Like a little Greek guy with what looks like a golf club. But yeah, you travel along, beat enemies to the beat. Gabrielle's Ghostly Groove Minis. I'm not entirely sure what these are. Gabrielle's Ghostly Groove is a super cute minigame with a spooky flair. These might be side stories or they might be extra songs. Groove Heaven. As cute little devil Rhymey, deliver a love letter to an angel while dancing to the beat. The game apparently has a story mode, and I love the design of the main character. She is super cute. I forgot to put this on my list, but I'm gonna throw it out now. Rhythm Heaven, I believe it's Megamix? Rhythm Heaven is a game series I have complicated feelings towards. I'm very familiar with and generally pretty good at rhythm games, except for Rhythm Heaven. And Megamix does have a demo you can download. I would recommend checking that out, because all of the Rhythm Heaven minigames are very creative, but I always... Oh, of course the heat has to kick on. But I always run into, like, an error, you know? Where, like, there's one minigame where I'm doing something to the beat, but just cannot seem to do it right. And I found this to be a problem with the demo of Megamix as well, but it is a very popular series, and I believe Megamix was digital only. So, yeah. Next up, we have Rhythm Thief and the Emperor's Treasure. You ever wonder what it would be like if, instead of puzzles, everything in the Professor Layton games got resolved via rhythm games? Well, that's essentially what playing this is like. It's nowhere near as good as the Layton games, unfortunately, and it never got the sequel that was clearly planned, but you can't deny it's creative. So I would recommend checking it out. The physical copies, I believe, go for a lot of money. Next up, we have Weapon Shop D. Omase. Part rhythm game, you are a young man working at a shop that rents weapons to people. It looks like it might be a little humorous. Now we're getting into random games a little bit again. The Bike Rider DX series. These games just seem to center around controlling a little stick person on a little stick bike, making your way through increasingly insane levels. Samurai Sword Destiny, a side-scrolling, story-driven adventure starring a female samurai named Akane. Now we got, I believe what is a sort of fighting game beaten up, the Senran Kagura series. I haven't played a lot of this series. It appears to be along the lines of a sexy fighting game with some story. Don't quote me on that, though. The first game, Burst, is getting some type of remake or remaster, though the original is super expensive if you try to get it physically. The sequel, Deep Crimson, still appears to be digital only, so you're only able to get it via the eShop. Now we're kind of going into, I guess you'd call them Defender games. God of Protectors, a game that recently got a sequel for the Switch. It seems to revolve around you picking one of a variety of classes and defending a princess or a castle from waves of enemies. Got a cute art style. Castle Conqueror EX. I got the demo for this one. Again, slightly cutesy art style. Got a little bit of a strategy game to it. This one might be less of a defender. I'm not entirely sure. Samurai Defender. This is one I have actually played. You stand atop the castle gate and you rain hell down on your enemies to stop them from breaching it. And I only played the demo, but I found it enjoyable enough to purchase. But thank you so much for watching. Please let me know in the comments if anything in this video caught your eye, and I'll catch you next time. Bye!